Hey, what's up everybody? Just want to thank you for joining me today. Today is not part of our Photography for Beginners tutorial series. Today I'm just going to talk about RAW versus JPEG and what it is. Now most DSLRs have the ability to shoot in both JPEG and RAW simultaneously. Now, although this is a good feature to have, it's not always practical, as doing so will fill up your memory card really quickly and leave you with limited hard drive space later on. You can always make a JPEG file later on in post-production, so if you're working on a RAW file, you can always save yourself a JPEG file if you have to. Additionally, we're going to whine about those pro photogs who shoot in both JPEG and RAW that mislead people into thinking that one or the other is better than the other. Now, this is a huge debate between people who shoot JPEG and RAW all the time. I'm middle ground. I'm going to tell you that both are good to shoot in. Both file formats have their advantages, and I'm going to show you and explain to you in this video when is the appropriate time to use it. Now, why would some pros choose to shoot in JPEG format? Well, it's usually because they're seasoned and they've been at it a lot longer. They know exactly how they want to set up their lights, they understand their camera very well, and they have a whole lot more time on their hands to take those pictures. Versus people like me, I don't have a whole lot of time to be spending at my photo shoots, worrying about the lighting and every little detail. I mean, of course I know what I'm doing and I know what kind of lighting I want to get. I'm not going to waste a whole lot of time while my client is there waiting for me to snap that shot. Although shooting in JPEG has its advantages, this is not the ideal time to do it. Now, again, if you have a whole lot of time on your hands, more power to you. Don't let any photog tell you that you are any less of a photographer just because you work more in post-production. That's a bunch of nonsense. Photography is art, and if you make that art in post-production, then you're a photographer and an artist. Now, why would other photogs shove RAW down your throat? It is because they're more concerned about how their images look later than they are at that moment. This is not to say that they don't know what they're doing, because they do. I'm partial to it and I work in that fashion. So when I'm doing magazines or I'm doing billboards or any kind of photography that requires a lot of post-production work, then I'm gonna use RAW. I am gonna side on RAW that, hey, it's all right to shoot RAW. Hey, it's okay to shoot JPEG. But like I said, there's a time and a place to use both of them, and I'm gonna explain that right now to you. Now, this does not make you any less of a photog, like I said before. It just makes you a better one, at least in my opinion. Although I am partial to utilizing post-production techniques as I envision my photo shoots, I'm providing a non-biased view of shooting in both file formats. However, most of these photogs that shoot in RAW, they're a special breed. Always talking about how magnificent they are and how they only buy the best of the best, and they're usually the ones sporting the big old cameras at amusement parks, small family functions, birthday parties, and so on. Okay, enough of all that. Let's move on to the real meat and potatoes and let's see what the real difference is between these two. Okay, so what is RAW? RAW is a digital negative. It provides you an unfiltered image of lights, colors, darks, shadows, all of that fun stuff. RAW files also save your metadata. What is metadata? Metadata is all the information that your camera stores in your image when you take that picture, such as what type of camera you use, what kind of lens you use, what was the focal length, what was your ISO, what was your shutter speed. All that information is recorded inside that image once you take your picture shooting in RAW. RAW files are also 2 to 4 times bigger than that of a large JPEG file. It also records up to 16 bits and over 4,000 lines of color shades. So that means if you take a picture of a gradient sky, your gradient is gonna be really smooth. It's not gonna be layered as you see in some images. So what is JPEG then? Joint Photographers Expert Group. It is a compressed file that your camera spits out for you. Smaller file size, typically between 4 to 8 megabytes. And it's a universal file format, so that means you can share that picture with anybody straight out of the camera. It records at 8 bits and only has 512 levels of color shades. So, how does your camera create a JPEG? Well, it takes your image and smashes it real small until it leaves you only with a 4 to 8 megabyte file and only 8 bits. So your camera is judging what to keep and what to throw out. Versus RAW, once you take that picture, what you see is what you get. Let's look on the screen here and check out the differences between the two. Let's see how much variance there is between a RAW and a JPEG file. You judge for yourself. So, here comes the big question. And drum roll, please. Close enough. When is the appropriate time to use JPEG? Journalism, sports, birthday parties, Disneyland, Magic Mountain, any place that you know that you are not gonna spend time doing post-production or very little. Now, seriously, why would you need to shoot RAW in those situations? You don't need to. So all you pro photogs, as much as you want to sit there and say,
I shoot RAW.
I don't shoot RAW in those places. I'm a pro photog, so does that mean I'm any less of a pro photographer? I still shoot in JPEG during those times. I will not shoot RAW. It's just a waste of space, waste of time, because I'm not gonna deal with it later. All right, guys, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a lot today. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the section. Don't forget about our contest that we've got coming up in 2 weeks. So if you don't know anything about it, click right here, bam. Watch this video and it'll tell you everything you need to know to qualify for the contest. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and also Blogger. So if you don't have time to watch these videos, hey, you can read them on the road and you can hear me in your head instead of seeing me. So take care, you guys, and don't be afraid to get creative. And I will see you guys later.
Peace.
Hi, I'm 18 megapixels.
Hi, I'm 10 megapixels.
Hi, I got a bigger lens.
I got a little lens. I shoot JPEG.
I shoot RAW.